Hi friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Nurse Mercy, a registered nurse and midwife. In today's video, we'll look at deoxyribonucleic acid or DNA, its importance, and how paternity test is done. So relax and enjoy the video. If this is your first time visiting my YouTube channel, you're warmly welcome. Please feel free to click on the subscribe button and ring the bell to get notified when a new video is uploaded. To my subscribers, thank you so much. You guys rock. DNA is a chemical name for the molecule that carries genetic instructions in all living things. It's the hereditary material in humans and almost all other organisms. Nearly every cell in a person's body has the same DNA. Deoxyribo means sugar, while nucleic acid means phosphate, and the bases. The bases go by the names adenine, cytosine, thymine, and guanine, also known as ACT and G. DNA is also organized structurally into chromosomes and then wound around nucleosomes. As part of those chromosomes, it is organized into genes, of which are pieces of DNA, which lead to observable traits. Those traits come from ribonucleic acid or RNA that is made from DNA, most commonly proteins. So observable traits of eye color or height or one thing or the other of individual come from individual protein. In sexual reproduction, humans create special cells called gametes that contain but one set of 23 chromosomes. During fertilization, the father's DNA unites with that of the mother to create a new unique set of fratricide chromosomes. DNA is referred to as the blueprint or the foundation which holds the information required for encoding the proteins and other cell components. An important property of DNA is that it can replicate or make copies of itself. The result of a DNA test uniquely identifies an individual. The test can be used to trace and identify ancestors. Most doctors will order this type of testing to check the condition of a newborn. The origin of one particular species will best be traced with the help of DNA tests. Now, how DNA or paternity test is done? It is done by collecting cheek cells found on the inside of a person's cheek using cheek or buccal swab. The swab is sent to the laboratory for test. Samples from the alleged father or mother and the child will be needed. With this testing, the parents will know if they are the biological parents of the child, and it helps to solve legal cases. The good news is that paternity testing can now also be performed while the woman is still pregnant, and it's done in two ways: invasive prenatal paternity test and non-invasive prenatal paternity test. In invasive prenatal paternity test, this procedure is called amniocentesis or chorionic villus sampling. Here, amniotic fluid is collected by inserting a needle through the pregnant mother's abdominal wall. This procedure is also accurate because the amniotic fluid is taken directly from the fetus, but there is risk of miscarriage. In DNA paternity test, the result is 0% when the alleged parent is not biologically related to the child, and the probability of parentage is typically 99.9% when the alleged parent is biologically related to the child. For non-invasive prenatal paternity test, here the procedure is done from blood draw with no risk of miscarriage, unlike invasive prenatal paternity test where there is risk of miscarriage. DNA tests can also be established when the biological father is not available and is called reverse paternity test. Reverse paternity test uses short tandem repeats, STR, alleles in the mother and her child, brothers of the alleged father, to create rough amalgamation. If you found this video helpful, please click on the subscribe button and ring the bell. Also click on the screen for more videos. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.